Blood supply to the heart, part 2. In the last video, we have already explained the importance of blood supply to the heart from the left side of the coronary arteries. Now, we will continue to the next part, right coronary artery RCA. The right coronary artery RCA distributes blood to the right side of the heart, which includes the right atrium, the right ventricle, and some part of the left ventricle. In addition to the right heart, RCA also supplies the heart conduction system, the SA node, the AV node, and the Purkinje fibers. The major branch of RCA arises at the inferior margin of the right ventricle and is called the right marginal artery. It supplies blood to the superficial portions of the right ventricle inferior margin or surface. RCA gives rise to the posterior interventricular artery on the posterior surface of the heart, and it travels in the posterior interventricular septum. It is also known as the posterior descending artery, as it runs along the posterior surface of the heart towards its apex, giving rise to branches that supply the interventricular septum. In addition to these two branches, many small atrial branches supplying the atria and ventricular branches supplying the ventricles also originate from the main trunk. Anastomosis of the heart. Here, it is imperative to mention about anastomosis. As mentioned before, anastomosis is the path where two branches of arteries join up and give dual blood supply to an area. If one coronary artery is obstructed by an atheroma, or thrombus, or an embolism, the second artery would still supply oxygenated blood to the myocardium. One can say that it is a protective mechanism of the body against the risk of ischemia. Most commonly, three areas of anastomosis are seen in the heart. The branches of the posterior interventricular branch of the right coronary combine with the left anterior descending branch of the left coronary in the interventricular groove or sulcus. A bigger anastomosis is between the left circumflex artery, a branch of the left coronary artery, and the right coronary artery in the atrioventricular groove. Another anastomosis is seen between the septal branches of the two coronary arteries in the interventricular septum. However, this protective mechanism in the myocardium is relatively restricted. First, this can only occur if the obtrusion progresses slowly, giving the anastomosis sufficient time to proliferate. The anastomosis is also somewhat small-scaled in the heart, so a coronary artery blockage, more often than not, results in myocardial infarction, causing the death of the tissue being supplied by that specific vessel. Variation. The left and right coronary arteries occasionally arise by a common trunk, or their number may increase to 3, the additional branch being the supernumerary coronary artery or right Wüsten's artery, which is smaller in size. In rare cases, a person will have the third coronary artery run around the root of the aorta. Coronary artery dominance. The artery that supplies the posterior aspect of the interventricular septum or the posterior descending artery determines coronary dominance. If the posterior descending artery is supplied by the right coronary artery, then the coronary circulation would be classified as right dominant. However, if a branch of the left artery, specifically the left circumflex artery, supplies the posterior descending artery, then the coronary circulation would be classified as left dominant. If the posterior descending artery is supplied by both the right coronary artery and the circumflex artery, then the coronary circulation would be classified as co-dominant. The usual picture of the population suggests that 70% of the people are right dominant, 20% co-dominant, and 10% are left dominant.